Hello, welcome my beloved saints, my sisters and brothers in Christ. This is Taisha, founder of Something for the People Ministry. Today's message is coming from 1 Samuel. This is chapter 2. I'll give you a little time if you want to follow along with me. We are under the Lord rejects Eli's household. So now we're talking about the priest Eli and how his sons had disobeyed the word of God and just never did. They never did anything for the Lord, just completely rejected the Lord. And we'll go into details about how God feels about this and what he did. And I hope that this will bless you. Okay, here we go. So it states, this is verse 30, chapter 2. As I said, it's under the Lord rejects Eli's household. Samuel 1, chapter 2. Okay, I promise that your house and the house of your father should go in and out before me forever. But now the Lord declares, far be it from me. For those who honor me, I will honor. And those who despise me shall be lightly esteemed. Behold, the days are coming when I will cut off your strength and the strength of your father's house. So that there will not be an old man in your house. Then in distress you will look with envious eyes on all the prosperity that shall be bestowed upon Israel. And there should not be an old man in your house forever. The only one of you whom I shall not cut off from my altar shall be spared to weep his eyes out, to grieve his heart. And all the descendants of your house shall die by the sword of men, and this that shall come upon your two sons, Hophni and Phinehas, shall be the sign to you. Both of them shall die on the same day, and I will raise up for myself a faithful priest who shall do according to what is in my heart and in my mind, and I will build him a sure house. And he shall go in and out before my anointed forever. And everyone who is left in your house shall come to implore him for a piece of silver or a loaf of bread, and shall say, please put me in one of the priest's places that I may eat a morsel of bread. So this is Lord, and he's prophesying what's to come. He's letting Eli know pretty much that this is what's to come. This is what's going to happen to you, to your family, to your legacy, to your children, to your generation to come. This is what's going to happen because you didn't, as the priest, you did not stop your sons from doing these things that they were doing, which was just not receiving the Lord, not receiving the Lord at all. So now I move on, you guys, to chapter 3, and this is verse 13. And I declare to him that I am about to punish his house forever for the iniquity that he knew. See, he knew about what his sons were doing. Because his sons were blaspheming God, he did not restrain them. Therefore, I swear to the house of Eli that the iniquity of Eli's house shall not be atoned for by sacrifice or offering forever. So no matter what Eli do, it's done. And that's what God is trying to tell us. Why he is here and open to us and we're able to go to him, we should. You know, once you turn from him, it's nothing left. It's nothing left. This is what's going to happen once you turn for him. And when you are over your children and you see that they're going the wrong way and you're held at a certain standard, it's up to us as parents to return our children back to God. It's up to us to intervene and intercede for our kids in Jesus' name. So, okay. Now I move on. It says, what is this? Verse 18. Still under chapter 3. It is the Lord. Okay, so Samuel lay until the morning. Then he opened the doors of the house of the Lord. And Samuel was afraid to tell the vision to Eli. See, God came to Samuel and told him that this was going to happen. And Samuel really didn't want to tell Eli what's to happen, but he did. So when he told Eli this, Eli replied, "It is the Lord. Let him do what seems good to him." So he probably, of course, that's his children. So he don't want the Lord to kill his kids, but it had to happen. You know, what God, when God say he's going to do something, it will be done. It will be done. And we have to understand that and know that his will be done. You know, we are just to talk to you for a little minute. I'll put my Bible to the side because I just use that particular story to get you to understand that when we are held accountable, when we know God, we know Lord, let's say, for example, me, I know Lord and I'm reading the Bible. I'm learning his laws. I'm learning his ways. I have children. And even though my children may grow old and they may go their own way, but it is for me to teach them the Lord. And it is for me to put that in them so it would never never depart them. So as parents, we need to make sure that we're instilling more into our children. We have, and actually, this is a message for me as well, y'all. Because some of the stuff that God brings to me is for me. And he says, if I understand it, maybe I can get someone else to understand it. That us as parents, you know, we're held accountable for our kids and we can intercede. And as he stated, Eli, he knew that his boys were worthless and they were laying around sleeping with different women and just not doing anything that God would want them to do, anything in the will of God. They were not. And Eli knew, and he did nothing to turn them, nothing to help them to stop it. He might have had a talk with them, but I don't see anything with him going in the Bible, going to the guard, saying, "Hey, help me with them, or do this, or do it." Just nothing, no petition, nothing that he did. So for that, Eli lost his boys. He lost his boys, and then he dropped dead, and then he died once he heard of what had happened. So pretty much, his boys was in a war with the Philistines, and I think in Israel or something like that. I don't want to mess it up, but they were shot. You know, I don't want to mess it up because I don't want to mess it up. Yeah, it was Philistines in Israel, and they did get killed. And what God said, it happened. Exactly as what Samuel prophesied would happen, it happened. So, y'all, when we come here and we tell y'all certain things and we prophesy certain things that are out of the Bible, pretty much just reading it to you, telling you, hey, this is what's to come, take it and run with it. Almost fly with it. Because that's why I like to read the Bible. I wouldn't tell you to turn to something if I'm going to add or take away from it. I want you to know exactly where we are and where we stand and what's going to happen. So I love you guys. I hope that you got this message. I ask that you read it, Samuel chapter 1-5, and just see what you get from that. And I'm going to continue to read Samuel because it goes more into in-depth with even with how they took the ark, the Philistines, and they had to give it back. You know, so what God's will is, it will be. It will be. Because if not, you don't want to go up against God. You don't want his hand against you. You know what I'm saying? You don't want his hand against you. I know I don't. So I'm sure that you don't either. If you have listened to me and made it this far, you don't either. So I come to you in love, no condemnation. Just with correction in the body of Christ. Because I want everybody that has kids or going to be mothers. Let's steer these children in the right direction. In Jesus' name. I love you guys. Y'all be blessed. Bye-bye.